Now we'll be creating a flange tree in MicroStation. So now we have to select the new file. Make sure that the seed is 3 seed 3D. You can browse it here and then select on the seed library. Click open and then type in your new file name, which is Flanged 3D test 2. Click save and then click open. Now you will see you have 4 views. You can use all of them or you can only select one. For me, I will maximize it using the view 1. But in order to do that, we have to set our working units first. Here, as you can see, the master unit is in meters, so we will use millimeters. Or you can also select feet, inches, or any imperial system or English system. So now we will select millimeters. We will close U1, U2, and U3. We only remain the top view. Here we can start drawing a circle for the profile of the flange. So we will create a circle on the drawing. Select circle, place on the origin or any points you prefer. Our radius for the flange will be 300. So click enter. So now we will have a 300 radius for the circle. Now we'll check the dimension. Select it. You can see the radius is 300. Click escape to exit. We will offset this to create the profile of the flange again. So here we select the circle. Select the move parallel or offset. We will offset it by 50 mm. So here we just type in, key in on the X 50 mm, press enter, and then select the location for the offset. It's either inside or outer of the circle. So we will provide it outer part and then click escape or right side of the mouse button. Now we will draw a line from the center to the top of the outer circle, to the edges. Trim it. Use the trim command, which is on the modify. Trim multiple. Select this the line inside the circle. We will use this line as a reference to draw in the hole on the flange. So here we create. We select circle, select the midpoint, and we'll key in a 10 mm radius or 20 mm diameter circle. Enter. If you want to check the dimension, you can see it's 10 mm radius at the end. Now we will delete or erase the line. Now the next is to have the circle arrayed so that it will be equally spaced within this flange. Here we will select the circle, select the array command. Here change this to polar. The number of items you want to place, 8. The delta angle will be 360 divided by 8 is 45 degrees. So here you will have to select from the center of the circle to the center of the inner circle. Then now you have arrayed the circle or for the bolt hole of the clutch. Click escape. Now we're using the top view, so we'll change our view to a isometric view, right isometric. Now we will extrude this outer circle, so we will create our first solid shape or object by using the solid command or extrude command, which is solid by extrusion. Click the solid by extrusion and then select the outer circle. You can key in the 50 mm as our thickness for the flange. Then click the upper part of the circle. Now we have drawn in our first object, which is a circular solid plate. We are going to cut the solid plate or object with all the inner circles profile. So in order to do that, we have to select the inner circles, selecting all the profiles. Then we have to use the cut solid by curves command. Keep cut direction bolt, cut mode true. Means it will cut on both sides and also all the way through the solid. So here you can see the at the bottom is accept cutting solid profile. Click the left button of your mouse to accept. You can see that the arrow is pointing upwards and downwards on the direction of the cutting. And then now it will ask us to select the target object, which is the outer circle. Select it, accept, click left, accept. As you can see now, if we change our view, display view to illustration and modeling, you can see that we have already cut from a solid circle flange. We have cut the internal opening and with the bolt opening for the flange. Hope this helps you with starting to work on this 3D modeling in MicroStation.